Hey guys, this is Josh here with Trillium Wild Edibles, and today I wanted to show you the differences between Yarrow, Queen Anne's Lace, and Poison Hemlock. If you look in your field guides, you will notice a warning about using these plants, saying that beginners should be cautious to avoid misidentification. In my opinion though, they look nothing alike, and this video shows you how different these plants really look.
And like I said earlier, in your field guides, they'll warn you about using Yarrow because you might confuse it with Queen Anne's Lace or Poison Hemlock. And you might be able to see what I'm talking about here. This is Queen Anne's Lace. These leaves look nothing like Yarrow leaves. They do look similar in a drawing, in a line drawing, and I guess that's probably why in the Peterson Field Guide they say that, because it's really hard to determine the technical details of the leaves through those line drawings. But in real life, up close and personal with these plants, you're really going to be able to see the differences. Queen Anne's Lace, its leaves are so much larger. They're not near as finely cut. There's just really no way to confuse these two. So there's the leaves of Queen Anne's Lace, and here are the leaves of Yarrow. I mean, you could say that Yarrow leaves look like feathers. Those, the ground rosettes of them here certainly resemble feathers, in my opinion. They even feel like feathers. They're very light, one touch, and they move real easy. Whereas the Queen Anne's Lace have more weight to them because they're larger. These leaflets are much larger. They're not near as finely dissected, so this plant has more mass. Doesn't feel near like a feather, and it doesn't look at all like a feather. Also, the stem of Queen Anne's Lace has these hairs running up and down it, whereas Yarrow, as you can see here, has this almost woolly-like covering instead of those little fine hairs. So those are just a couple of the quick differences between Yarrow and Queen Anne's Lace. And here you guys can see Poison Hemlock. Here you can see these white flowers with 5 petals. And here you can see the shape of these leaves. You can see what I mean, how these leaves look nothing like Yarrow, and they look nothing like Queen Anne's Lace. Queen Anne's Lace's leaves are a lot more finely dissected. Yarrow's leaves are even finer than Hemlock and Queen Anne's Lace, and there are a lot more leaflets on Yarrow than there are on Hemlock and Queen Anne's Lace. But here you can see the distinct shape on these leaves. You can see just how big these leaves are in comparison to Queen Anne's Lace or Yarrow. So that's something to keep in mind, and that's something I wanted to show you guys, so that way you don't pick the wrong plant and you don't poison yourselves. Also, the stem of Poison Hemlock, as you can see here, has all of these purple splotches on it, whereas Queen Anne's Lace and Yarrow has neither of those. You can see just how big the stem on Poison Hemlock gets. This plant gets absolutely huge. Here you can see this plant here. This plant's taller than I am. This plant's at least 6, 6.5 feet, maybe even 7 right now. Also, the growing environment. I usually never find Queen Anne's Lace or Yarrow next to Hemlock, because I usually always find Hemlock, as you can see here, on the edge of fields. Sorry about the noise, they're doing some tree work down the road. But this is where I always find Hemlock. I never find it anywhere near Yarrow. Now, you may be different. So I thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you learned something. If you want to learn more about edible or medicinal plants, make sure to subscribe.